But staying with this pack, Sunteck Realty reported earnings post-market hours. Overall, if you go to see in terms of the quarter as well, revenues have gone up by 50%, profits have improved by 65%, and margins have remained pretty much stable at 52% versus a 52.5. In terms of the pre-sales, new bookings, they're up around 6%. Collections have gone up by around 38%. Let's connect with Sumesh Mishra, President and COO at Business Development and Strategy at Sunteck Realty. Welcome to the show, Sumesh, and a very good morning. Overall, it's a pretty good set of numbers that we've seen in the fourth quarter. What has led to this kind of an uptick? Because new bookings, not a major up move, but it's mainly the collections that have moved higher this time around.
Hi, good morning to you and all the viewers. So, thank you for taking the through the entire set of numbers. So I'll straight away come to the point of why the numbers have, shown this jump. So, in terms of our execution, so all the three projects of BKC are now delivered and, all the residents have started moving in. So approximately 50 apartments have already been occupied and residents have started moving from across Bombay and other regions. So that has been, better than even our expectation, and that has led to, a lot of payments which we receive on possession. So that has helped us in taking, up our collections, as well as the Oshiwara District Cente project, the Sunteck City project, where Avenue 1 and Avenue 2 projects are moving, at a very fast pace in terms of execution. So where we are looking at delivering the Avenue 1 project, the idea is to deliver the project in the next 12 to 15 months. And even Avenue 2, we have been able to, build almost like a 2 to 2.5 slabs every month. So which has upped the, so there has been good pre-sales in these projects, and the collections have improved because of faster execution. So that has been one of the major contributors. And with the way the Sunteck City project is shaping up, where we are looking at first phase of delivery in the next 12 to 15 months, we are again gearing up for launching the other phases of the project. So the overall project is divided into six phases, and we look forward to launching more phases in the next 2 to 3 quarters.
Right. So, Subesh, if you could just help me understand, what's the kind of, inventory that you're sitting on? Break up with regards to, complete inventory, ready inventory versus near complete inventory.
So I'll just take you through the portfolio. So we have a portfolio of 25 projects, which gives us about 30 million square feet of sale area, a developable area. Out of that, out of these 25 projects, we have completed 9 projects so far. And in these 9 projects, we have a net sales value. So we have overall sales value of about 2,200 crore rupees. Primarily, a major contributor in this will be the BKC projects. So out of 2,200 crore rupees, approximately 2,000 plus crores will be from the three BKC projects where we have the ready inventory, where OC is received and it is completely habitable. Apart from these 2,200 crore rupees of ready inventory, we have 6 other projects which are under execution, which includes the Sunteck City Avenue 1 and Avenue 2 projects. So these projects will have a sale value of about 1,500 crore rupees. So if you take the 9 plus 6 projects, so approximately 15 projects gives us a net overall sale value of approximately 3,700 crore rupees. And then there are other projects, so other 10 projects, which includes the 16 acres of Sunteck City, Goregaon, Oshiwara District Center. That gives us an additional, including a sales value plus the terminal value of the commercial projects. That will be another 6,500 to 7,000 crore rupees, which will come in the near future.
Right. So, Sumesh, what I want to ask you over here is that from the numbers that you're giving me, it seems that you already have a huge ready inventory that you're sitting on, wherein the moment we see an uptick with regards to where consumer sentiment goes, it will directly accelerate your cash flow generation versus making any further investments that could be required in regards to construction. Now, in that scenario, what's the kind of cash flow that you are looking at that could come in FY19 then?
See, I will stay away from giving any forward-looking statement, but this year we did a collection of almost 530 crore rupees plus. And, with the current inventory that you can see, 2,200 plus 1,500 crore rupees of inventory, which will be hitting the completion in the next 18 to 24 months. With a 3,700 crore kind of inventory with us, you can see that the collections, now that the execution cycle, first execution cycle was completed with the BKC projects, and second execution cycle will be completed with the Oshiwara Business District Cente project. So we can see that the collections should move, in the similar way, and the sales also with the delivery status. Once we deliver the first phase of Avenue 1 in the Sunteck City project, you will see the collections also moving, at a much, much faster pace than what we are doing.
Okay.
It is already improving 20% to 20%, and you can go on, you can see the collection number further bettering because of these ready status and the delivery of these projects.
Okay. And with regards to where rental income is concerned, what's the outlook looking like? How much of your revenues do you think would come in from the rental portfolio in FY19?
So currently our rental portfolio is very small, but what we intend to do is, now that we have historically we have been focusing 80% on the residential side, now in Goregaon, in Oshiwara District Center, we are just abiding, we are present in one of the the back office hub or the mid office hub of Mumbai. So there we intend to develop about 2.6 million square feet of commercial cum retail asset. So there about 2 million square feet will be commercial commercial space, and 0.6 million will be retail and some bit of hospitality. So overall, these 2.6 million square feet we intend to deliver in the next three years, and there the intended the creation of rental portfolio will be in the range of 450 to 475 crore rupees annually. And that is how we are sitting on this, with a very strong balance sheet with negligible debt. What we intend to do is to further strengthen the company and balance sheet. This rental portfolio of 450 to 475 crore rupees will take us to the next level. And this is what we intend to start in the next two quarters. And we're working towards that.
Right. And with regards to the MMR and extended suburban area as well, where you have recently entered into a JDA with DDPL Global Infrastructure and Unicorn Infra Projects, what's the outlook on that? Because affordable housing is also something which is a major push and a booster for real estate companies, because you do have a large-scale development over there. Apart from that, the approval status is also pretty much on the positive end. And with regards to where the location is concerned, is also a key positive. If you could just help us understand the commencement of the project details, as well as how is the cost management and execution going to look like?
Yeah, so as you rightly pointed out, this is towards the western belt of Mumbai metropolitan region, and this is a location between Borivali and Virar. This is called Naigaon. So we have entered into a joint development agreement of 100 acres, and this will be a project which will, the size of the project will be between 10 to 12 million square feet. So it's a very large project, and obviously we wanted to tap the affordable housing segment through aspirational homes. And also this is, this is in line with our philosophy of being asset light. Wherever, we have gone out and we have tried to, take a initially to enter into this particular segment. And also with regards to the status of the project, the basic approvals and the major key approvals like the environmental clearance and overall layout, those approvals are already there. So we have entered into a, combination of asset light as well as a distressed asset. But looking at the location, which is a very, very good connectivity with the Borivali and the suburbs of Mumbai, we believe that, we'll be able to launch this project in the next next 1 to 2 quarters. And where the first phase, sort of 10 to 12 million square feet, we look forward to launch the about 1.5 million square feet of area in the next 1 to 2 quarters. So we are aggressively working towards launching these projects in the next 3 to 4 months. And you'll see that hitting the ground. And we'll be coming up with the fifth brand for this segment, which will be for the mid-income value homes. And we will try to give luxury in this particular segment, between which will be about 30 to 40 lakh rupees is what the ticket size we are looking at.
And this will also help us in. And very lastly, Sumesh, what I want to check with you is that the expectation was that once RERA came into practice, the uptick was expected with regards to where sale of residential projects goes. But when we speak to a lot of marketing companies with regards to real estate, what their opinion is that the sales has not picked up as expected post RERA. And now that you have the IBC also with regards to a relief to home buyers, do you think both these put together could lead to of some bit of an uptick with regards to residential sales?
Oh yes, in fact, we have seen, and I think almost every developer will agree that what is attracting the buyers today is a completed project, and that is the reason our BKC project, you can see that the uptick is good, the realizations are higher, and the confidence of the ultra-luxury segment is high because of the completed status. And this is across the board. You will see a good number, set of numbers for projects which are already completed. And second is the affordable ticket size. And that is where even our Sunteck City project, which is a very attractive ticket size of 1.5 crore rupees onward, and now with the Naigaon launching in a further attractive ticket size, we are very comfortably placed. And what we have seen in the, and you know, even the other players in the market, the smaller ticket size or the right ticket size at the right location has done phenomenal business for almost all the good brands. And that's why you can see that the share or the pie of good brands, you know, and organized players is increasing. And this is, we are on the brinks of completing 1 year from the entry of RERA. So I think things are only moving on northwards, and you will see further improvement in the next two quarters. That uptick we have already seen in the last quarter, and we continue to see that confidence coming into the market. And it will just take maybe two or three quarters more where you can see the significant changes in the buying patterns and in terms of closures for all the developers.
Right. All right, Sumesh. Thank you for speaking to BTVI and sharing your views as well. So uptick in terms of a consumer sentiment is something which is pretty much on the radar with regards to where real estate companies go. And with that, it could act as a booster for housing finance companies as well. So that's going to be a segment of the portfolio that we will continue to focus on. The stock as well seeing gains of almost 1.5% and almost 95 to 100% is the kind of up move that we've seen on our Sunteck Realty in the last 1 year. But let's quickly slip.